You're a chief of staff in the army.
In the army.
Okay, so that wasn't the political appointment.
No, no, no. In the army, a very powerful position because everything in the army, like Jesus Christ in the army. Mm-hmm. Everything, you can't go to a father except through Christ. Mm-hmm. So you go, nothing goes to say without capacity through me. You are actually a very powerful position.
No, you're a big man.
Well, you know, if you're a very powerful position. And Akufo was a first class gentleman. These were fantastic officers. Mm. Fantastic.
All of them.
All of them. I mean, this is what I'm saying. Ghana, please learn lessons from the loss of these lives.
But they were murdered, man. They were shot, killed.
They, you know, what crime did Christ commit? No crime. He died for us. These people lost their lives for people like you and I. But now the crime that they are supposed to have died
no,
to see.
No, I mean, Christ,
there was no crime.
Christ offered to be slaughtered for whatever purpose. That is, you refer to them as gentlemen. And then they were lined up and shot one after the other. And 30 years, 40 years after, we have nothing to show for
nothing it. To show for, and nothing to learn to show that you have learned a lesson. There are lessons to be learned. You know, if people who did nothing from what you and I are saying, can be slaughtered in cold blood like that, then some of us who are in power today.
You know, you showed me the picture of your intake, the group, and you talked about Feli. And I could feel the emotions when you mentioned Feli.
Yeah. You know, when those people were killed, I mean, I still think about them. You should not forget, because, and you should do well to remember them and to learn something from them.
See, we dance around this issue a bit too much. I mean, if they die as martyrs or in martyrdom, you can understand how we can accommodate the whole essence of it. But it's somebody's excitement and
The sad thing is that if you look at President Rawlings himself, I became chief of defense staff, so 79, so I was aware about what was going on. I wasn't part of the FIC, but I was head of the military. Mm-hmm. FIC was the government, so we didn't have much in common. But it came that he was 33 years old at the time. Now he's 72. I think about 32 years old. At the time. Mm-hmm. And I wouldn't say he wasn't an army officer, he was an Air Force officer. Mm-hmm. The difference between the army and the Air Force, the difference in our training, in our profession. Mm-hmm. And he hadn't had much experience in command. He was a pilot, mm-hmm. fighter pilot, take his plane, take off. But at that time, he had to take decisions. And given his age, and the pressure on him, I don't think he was in control of what happened. He wasn't in control.
Well, so
I wouldn't say that he is not to carry the blame.
No, of course, he carries the blame.
He carries the blame, you know. But
he won't share that with anybody, in my estimation.
You know, and so I'm not trying to excuse him. But you have to understand
the context.
The context in which this has mm-hmm. happened.
Well, we will understand, but we will not wish that it be repeated.
Yeah, I was in the guard room with Bwachi. Dr. Joe Abisi around.
He is around. Yeah, he's around.
Get his number. I'm trying to call him. I'm trapped. I can't get hold of him.
Get his number.
Joe Abisi, myself, Bwachi, Jinamidu, Jamil was among. I think was among.
You were put behind guard room?
No, in the June 4th. You had to report. I mean, your life.
Oh, you are invited?
Yes, no, because, I mean, they were shooting, I mean, arresting and killing officers, senior officers. So for your own safety, you'd be safer to report. I could do an info and a wife. I spent a day on my roof. My roof is bushy like this. So when I'm in green uniform, you'll be able to identify me.
So you entered the roof. And where was your wife?
They were in the house. And my children, they were little children. And you know, but it was safer because safer for them and for me.
Yeah.
So I was on the roof at the vantage point. I could see around me.
So this is General Nuno Mensah, you know, running away and hiding in the roof, and this is a sterling military officer with all the accolades and awards from no lesser place than Sandhurst, running away from the bullet. we'll be right back.
Before you go, when you are under fire, first action that you take over.
Yes.
Even if you're General Montgomery, you don't run away. You take over
in the roof.
Yes. To be able to observe and then take action.
So you observe.
You don't walk into the open and say I'm here. Yeah, shoot me.
You observe it from there. Okay, we'll come back. We'll come back to this one.